Now that we have created the building geometry, our next task is to add thermal zones and subsurfaces. Again, we will create a backup file, save as version 3. Next, go to the geometry tab. Select the Editor tab. It starts in the Floor Plan tab. We have completed the floor plan and geometry. The next task is to assign thermal zones to each space or a collection of spaces. Select the Assignments tab. Expand the Thermal Zones tab and add a thermal zone. We will call this Thermal Zone 101. For this, we need to know how many thermal zones there are. Looking at the mechanical drawings, you'll note that pretty much every space has its own thermal zone. Starting with the apparatus bay, we'll do thermal zone 101. We can click the duplicate button to create another one, 102, and so on. Now that we have created the thermal zones, we can contract the thermal zone tab by clicking this upper right button here, and we can assign the thermal zones. For thermal zone 101, we select thermal zone 101, and then we select the space 101. Select thermal zone 102, select the space 102. And so on. Now that we have added the thermal zones, we can move on to adding subsurface components. Go to the Components tab on the top, select it. The first component that we will add is this door here. The door is approximately 7 foot by 3 foot. Select the drop-down menu and select Door. Click the plus button. You can expand the menu here, and you will note that this is approximately a 3 foot by 7 foot door. To place the door, just hover over the top of the space. You will note that there's an icon showing a door here with approximate size. Click to drop the door in place. Next, we have to add these windows. These windows are approximately 3 foot by 6 foot. Click the drop-down menu, click Window, click Plus to add a window. 3 foot by 6 foot. The sill height is approximately 9 foot high. Again, go to the space, hover over the location, and click it to drop the window in place. Do this for all the windows and doors. For this door, it will be a glass door, so we have to duplicate one of the doors and change the type to glass door. Same situation with this door. And finally, the overhead doors. We will select overhead door type. And that completes the addition of the windows and doors. Click the collapse button to collapse the tab, and you can now see that we have placed all of the windows and doors. And that concludes our lesson for today. You will want to click the merge button again to merge the geometry with the OpenStudio model. Click the 3D view tab to see the final product.